The action of the film begins in 2036. The war between Russia and Ukraine is raging at full speed. Master Sergeant Miller participates in a firefight, informing the base that one of the partners is with the enemy. The sergeant decides to rescue his soldier. During the rescue operation, one of the servicemen was wounded. At this time, at the base, Thomas Harp and his partner Bale are watching what is happening through a drone. Harp discovers an unidentified vehicle and asks for permission to destroy the danger. Sergeant Miller categorically forbids shooting, as there are two of his soldiers there. Harp tells Bale to get an airstrike order from Captain Bryden. Harp gets rejected, as the blow can hook their allies. Harp decides to launch an airstrike on his own, disobeying the sergeant and the captain. For violating a direct order, Thomas Harp was sent to Captain Leo as a serviceman. Upon arrival, Harp searches for Captain Leo. One of the soldiers directs him to Colonel Ectard. The colonel sent Harp to Block 13 and made it clear that Captain Leo was not an ordinary person. Entering the block, Harp found Captain Leo. He signed the papers and later they had a conversation in which they mentioned Viktor Koval, the commander of the Red Army. It turns out that Viktor Koval is suspected of the death of 25,000 people as he dropped a bomb from Russian uranium on Kiev. Captain Leo has received information that a third of Russia's nuclear weapons are in Ukraine and Koval wants to get to him in the next day to destroy them. Captain Leo tells Harp that they are now going to the hospital to deliver the vaccine. New acquaintances begin to change into civilian clothes in order to save themselves from the danger of becoming cannon fodder. In the process of changing clothes, Harp saw that the commander-in-chief's body consists of robotic mechanisms similar to camouflage, which merges with the environment. After leaving the building, Captain Leo tells Harp that he is a robot and that he chose him because he needs a person who thinks outside the box. The captain walked away, ordering Harp to carry the bags to the car. At that moment, Sergeant Miller's subordinates attacked Harp and beat him for not following orders and the death of two soldiers. Captain Leo stopped the dialogue. Everyone got into their cars. Upon arrival, Captain Leo informs the residents that they are taking the vaccine to the hospital and shakes hands with one of the locals. The captain orders his subordinates to clear the area. As soon as the captain moved away from his soldiers, residents began shooting from houses. Many soldiers died. Captain Leo orders Harp to take the vaccine and walk. Sergeant Miller informs them that they will sort out what happened and tells them to go together. They manage to get away from the shooting scene and go out into the field. Colleagues talk about Leo's functions and joke about roboticism. Along the way, they see all the consequences of a brutal war. They stumble upon a mass grave teeming with the corpses of civilians in the country. They reach the refugee shelter. There, Leo says that he has earned the trust of people. He created this shelter and gave the refugees a roof over their heads. They got to the hospital. At the moment when they were giving the vaccine, one of Viktor Koval's men started shooting from the roof of one of the walls of the camp. During the shootout, Captain Leo managed to shoot him. The captain tried to get information about Koval from the mercenary, but could not find out anything from him and gave him to the inhabitants of the camp to be torn to pieces. After the incident, Harp wants to report to the base that there are rebels and shooters in the camp. Leo says it doesn't make sense. A conflict begins between them, after which Harp does not intend to get into the car with Leo, but he understood that he could not cope alone, so he still went with the captain. While they were driving, Leo said that Harp had done the right thing by disobeying orders and lowering the air weapon. Harp believes that many operations should not be performed by artificial people, to which Leo said that he was created according to the system to portray a person and that he can act on his own thoughts in extreme situations, just like Harp. Harp and Leo arrived at another peaceful settlement. It is under guard. There is Savali, who gives information to Leo. That's why they came there. Sophia already knew about the incident at the hospital. She believes that Viktor Koval is already close to nuclear weapons, explaining that it can only be activated by entering a second classified data. After the Cold War, the weapon got to an agent of the Federal Drug Control Service, who hid the data in a safe. They believe that Viktor Koval paid a lot of money to get the data and that the weapons are hidden very close to them. Leo is interested in how to get access codes. Sophia says that to do this, you need to buy ammunition, and you need to buy it somewhere in their city. Leo assumes that everything you need is on the black market, and Sophia said that there is only one person to access this type of weapon. She spoke about him in a negative way, exposing him as a traitor. This is a merchant named Vary Koshlak. Leo asked Sophia to take them to the merchant, as they also need weapons. The captain gives Sophia money to buy weapons, to which Harp reacts negatively, saying that it is illegal. Unsatisfied with the answer, he went out into the courtyard of the shelter. Later they went to the market. Upon arrival, they met Vary Koshlak's partner. Leo attacked him and a wall broke through behind the man. When they entered, they saw three more people. The captain will skillfully cope with them and found the merchant himself. When Leo asked him a question, his partner came to himself, whom the captain attacked in the first place and tried to fight back. Sophia reacted quickly and neutralized the enemy. Koshlak tried to escape, but the captain managed to stop him. The merchant answered the necessary questions, after which Sophia killed him. Leo and Harp got into his car and drove to the address that Vary Koshlak had told them. According to him, there is a safe there. On the way, Leo says that he needs Harp in order not to be turned off at the moment when he violates orders and Koval does not win. They arrived at the place. Leo asked Harp to cut out a tracking device from his back, since the Russians have tracking devices, because of which the enemy sees the location of the robot captain. When they entered the building, they realized that Koval was inside. The captain ordered Harp to call Colonel Ektard and inform him that Viktor Koval was next to the safe. Shooting started inside. The captain ordered Harp to take civilians out of the building. Leo dealt with all the opponents, but suddenly a robot appeared in the room. He started shooting at the captain, to which he did not lose his head. Harp threw him a grenade launcher, with which he destroyed the robot. Leo followed Koval. At this moment, Harp calls Colonel Ektard and asks for help. Harp led the people out of the room, and at that moment reinforcements arrived. There were shouts in the building. The Russians were taking people out with weapons at their heads, with threats of reprisal. One of the robots fired at the opponents and a shootout began. At that moment Leo almost got to Koval, but unfortunately he did not notice the armed man and he shot at the captain. Harp managed to save the surviving civilians. He led them out through the back entrance to the cafe. Ektard informed Harp that they were going to launch a rocket into the building. At that moment, Leo, on the roof, shot his opponent, who had the codes. A rocket was fired into the building. Harp and the girl he saved miraculously managed to survive, and Leo still remained on the roof with the codes. Leo puts Harp in the car, and they drive in an unknown direction. Harp tries to order Leo to return to base and obey his directives. Leo says that he can act according to his mind and refuses. Leo continued the conversation. He told Harp that he had cut out a security sensor from his back, not a location tracking sensor, and that after Harp called Ektard, the colonel thinks Leo has been eliminated. After a difficult conversation, Leo knocked Harp out. Harp woke up in one of the refugee camps and was almost immediately captured by soldiers. Harp was taken to Sophia. It turns out that she is the head of the resistance. Sophia claims that Koval was not in the building and he is still alive. Also, Sophia makes it clear that Leo remains on the side of the resistance. He decided to take such a step to take the missiles from Koval under the control of the resistance. Leo was with Viktor Koval at that moment. He informed Koval that he was able to get the codes and accuses him of attempted murder. Koval admits that he is afraid of Leo and wanted to be safe and kill the captain. Leo demands that Koval tell him where the perimeter is. Harp suspects that Leo may be using codes and weapons for his own purposes. Sophia proves the opposite to him, claiming that she has known the captain for a long time. Also, the head of the resistance claims that the main enemy in this war is the United States, since this war is very beneficial to them in subordination to Russia. Harp understands that Leo and the resistance intend to drop bombs on the United States, thereby killing millions of innocent people, but on their part this is only collateral damage. At that moment, Captain Leo dealt with Koval and his allies, after which he learned the location of the rocket launcher and went there to activate it. Sophia let Harp go, knowing he wouldn't hurt them. Harp got to the base. He began to tell Sergeant Miller and Colonel Ektard about Leo, that he had not been destroyed and was now AWOL. They didn't believe him, but he could convince them and they agreed to start looking for him. Harp contacted Bale and asked to find a car by drones. With their help, they managed to track Leo and figure out where he was going. Harp went after him. Suddenly, the screens on which images from drones are displayed turned off at the base. Harp got into an abandoned factory on the border with Russia. There he notices several dead guards and realizes that Leo is already inside. Leo is trying to launch a rocket launcher at this moment, activating devices from the USSR. Harp got up and found several corpses. Hot on Leo's trail, Harp hears the engine start. At this moment, Leo attacks Harp from around the corner. Leo strangles his former partner, but Harp pulls out a gun and shoots the captain. Harp faints, and the wounded Leo continues to activate weapons that will destroy an entire superpower. A few minutes later, Harp regains consciousness and hears Sergeant Ekstard, who reports that a drone has flown to his aid in order to eliminate Leo along with the missiles if anything happens. Harp does not respond to the Allies and intends to kill Leo with his own hands. He rises and picks up a weapon that is equipped with armor-piercing cartridges. The main character shoots at the captain, but he stands to the last to delay time. Harp manages to severely injure Leo and he falls. Leo talks about the intentions of the United States and believes that he is obliged to destroy this country in order to protect the whole world. Harp hesitates to agree with Leo and believes that humanity will sooner or later understand itself and stop useless pursuits between states. There are 40 seconds left before the launch of the missiles. Harp hesitates to kill Leo and leaves him mortally wounded at the sight of the rocket takeoff. He gives the command to launch a rocket from a drone in 30 seconds to eliminate the takeoff of Soviet missiles. After the explosion at the rocket launcher, Harp reports to Ekstard that he has successfully completed the mission. The sergeant respectfully praises the main character and says that he is free and can go home to his family. This is where the film ends. Thanks for watching. I love you.